It was a tumultuous day in chambers. This is the third sitting of council in the city of Johannesburg. Proceedings barely started, and already there were major disruptions which went on for hours.
Engagement at this level in this space is usually contentious and vociferous as council members turn up the heat on the ruling administration of the city of Johannesburg, questioning decision making. However, at this sitting of council, the order of business never materialized simply because of a spat between ANC councillors and the Speaker of the House, who came under fire for a decision he took to throw two ANC councillors out of today's meeting.
The issue raised by the ANC's chief whip, who was asked to leave chambers, was on the point of speaking time. The ANC felt strongly that as they received a 45% vote from the electorate in recent elections, they ought to receive speaking time accordingly. They also wanted the remaining parties to receive speaking time according to their percentage gains during elections.
My point that I was talking to was that if they do an increase on the number of, on the speaking time of minorities, what the ANC would expect from the Speaker and the Chief Whip and Council is that the ANC would be given incremental time according to the time that's offered to minorities. We didn't decline the issue of what they offer, but we are saying incremental time must also be shared. If they give them two more, they must understand that in the ANC time allocated, two would be added according to our strength that is there. And that was the issue. Then I raised an issue to say we mustn't forget that this coalition, which is a minority, came out of a marriage that was between the EFF and the DA. And that marriage, actually, all residents and South Africans in Africa on the 22nd of August would remember that day when that was shown. And the EFF were applauding, clapping hands that they have ousted the ANC into power while the ANC is in majority. And to my surprise, when has the word marriage been an insult?
The ANC's chief whip also alleged that he believes the Speaker of the House took instructions directly from the EFF, rendering his position as biased and prejudicial.
The ANC position...
No, this council, he must not come here and mislead the people. He cannot say that the EFF and the DA are in a fight and say...
No, he can't say that. He can't say... But he's misleading the people, this council. No. This is how this organization that claims to understand democracy and in Joburg, and that claims to respect our masses, disrespect media, disrespect when a party takes on media on the issues that they've raised and we are responding positively, because they would be given time by the media to respond, as we are saying. But they've shown disrespect. And this is a continuation of how the EFF behaves in council. And we're asking the Speaker to say, can the Speaker take a posture that shows independent thinking, that shows that he doesn't take side, and follow what the guideline says on what the presiding officer should do?
We asked the EFF to respond to the allegations.
I do not know if they have a problem per se with the EFF, but I'm sure they have a problem with the fact that they are no longer in power here in the city of Johannesburg, and that the looting that have been happening for the previous 20 years cannot continue. And I'm sure maybe it's the fear that with the DA running the city, they might be able to uncover a lot of the corruption practices that have been happening, and they might be able to expose them. So I think that is the biggest fear that they have. The DA and the EFF are not in a marriage, are not in a coalition, are not in any relationship. We're not in a coalition with the DA, we're not in any marriage whatsoever with the DA. Actually, it is an insult to use the EFF and the DA in one sentence. Look, we did not give the DA our vote. We voted against corruption. We voted against politics of patronage. It could have been the IFP that could have been running to be mayor or to run the city of Joburg. We could have voted with them. We voted with the opposition against the politics of patronage, against corruption, against the arrogant ANC.
Do you think we will eventually get down to business of council today, Mayor?
Well, I think looking at what has transpired the last few hours, it looks like ANC is determined to make the city ungovernable. They don't care about service delivery to our people after being punished on the 3rd of August for failing our people. So they are saying to our people, government is about them. It's got nothing to do with our people, particularly the poor members of our society. You can imagine this disruption, what it's going to do to service delivery. such a trivial matter of talking about speaking times. And us and the other parties had agreed in advance. It is there, including ANC in advance. They've agreed on this in whippery. So instead of dealing with this matter to whether they accept the outcome of what was agreed, so that all the parties are given an opportunity to speak in council, then they talk about marriage, they talk about fat and set, completely irresponsible, just to insult other people. And fortunate enough, EFF took exception to this. Us as a DA, we're taking serious exception to this. And because they were determined to just disrupt us, that's really what has happened. Obviously, one major announcement that we had to make was the appointment of the city manager, who's supposed to start on the 1st of January. So we will still continue with this matter. If this council doesn't continue today, we'll call an emergency council meeting one of these days to improve that, so that people of Johannesburg can see what kind of ANC they had in the past. Luckily, they voted them out of power, and I think it's up to our people to actually see through them that ANC, it's about them. And I feel the reason why they don't want us to succeed is because you will see the next few days cases of corruption that I'm going to let people of Johannesburg and South Africa know that I've uncovered. And this process today makes me to speed them up, so that I let people of South Africa know of the looting that has been happening in this city in the last few years.
Finally, we got to the Speaker of the House, who came under intense fire from the ANC following his decision to kick them out of council.
I think they showed disrespect in the council. Simply the one continuing to chant the ANC councillors to keep on singing and disrupt the proceedings within the House. I think the issue that led to that was basically Councillor Mukasa standing up and insulting the opposition and obviously the coalition. I asked him to retract 3 times. He refused, and at some point on the 3rd occasion he then retracted the words that he used firstly, and then replaced them with even worse derogatory term. I think the only thing that is lacking within this administration currently is that we don't have security. We don't want to make the same mistake that Parliament did in the first place, letting officers inside the council chamber that are armed, number one, and that are controlled by the SAPS rules, in the sense that you cannot allow a police officer or either JMPD member to conduct your security within council.
I also asked Degama to give us a sense of where he has to draw the line in council in the spirit of democracy.
I think in the spirit of democracy, all political parties have whippery. All political parties do have a caucus, and obviously caucuses must take a leadership decision. When somebody is asked to leave the House, the caucus or the caucus leadership, in this case, Councillor Park Style, should take the decision that, yes, the Speaker has made a ruling, please leave the House. It's as simple as that.
Eventually, towards the end of the day, the Johannesburg City Council approved the appointment of Dr. Indivorniswani Lukwareni as its new city manager. The 2 ANC councillors who were kicked out remained in chambers for the rest of the day. Nishina Mohammed for Joburg Today.